Hello friends, this is Ash, and in this video, I'm going to be testing another build. I chose to use the Demogorgon, as for some reason I always like to do my totem heavy builds on him. I'm not sure why. I guess it might be because he has a built-in mechanic where you can use it to see if they're going to get rid of your totems. However, in the first game I totally forgot about it. In the second game and third game, we actually ended up three games on this one. We leaned more heavily into it, and one of them got turned into a really long game for that very reason. So in him, we're bringing crowd control, blocks the window for 60 seconds after its prime performs a rush vault. This is actually really fun. Never actually used this perk before. See how that goes. See the aura of destroyed totems, and we can relight them. So with one relit totem, survivor's repair speed is reduced by 30%. 2, healing speed is reduced by 30%. 3, survivor's recovery speed being downed is 30% reduced. 4, decreases survivor's exit gate opening speed by 30%. And if you have all 5, you keep all of these because they can't destroy the totems. Never actually gotten all 5 stacks of this, however, usually 1 or 2 helps slow down the game anyway, significantly for more than one reason. They try to cleanse the totems more, they try to go get the Pentimento totems, and even if you don't keep the totems up, you're still slowing down the game quite a bit. We're bringing in Dying, we'll reveal their auras if they're near a dull totem, and it'll give us another chance for a totem to not get destroyed, plus Pentimento if Undying does get destroyed. Thrill of the Hunt, gain 10% more blood points for actions in the Hunter category through each token, and Survivor's cleansing and blessing speed is reduced by 10%. And as we're bringing the Demogorgon, he's got a whistle that lets us know if they're near his portal, so we could just, theoretically, we could just put a portal down next to the totems and we'll know if they're going to cleanse it or if they're near the totem. And increases the time for survivors to seal portals, as we don't want them to get rid of our portals near the totem. We'll see how these games go. If you guys have a build that you'd like to see done, leave it in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video, and I hope you enjoy. I make myself laugh sometimes. Don't worry about it. This is fine. Hey Dash, how are you? You're having a good day. It's Friday. If you had one and spilled cologne on it before, then you know what an angry ball sack looks like. Can't confirm. I've not experienced that. Not found a single survivor. Should have brought the whistle. Thank you. Okay. Also, on a side note, how does one spill cologne on their ball sack? Like, how does this happen by accident? What's with all the personal questions? You're the one that volunteered the information about the cologne and the ball sack, not the rest of us. I just want to know how that happens. If you have a ball sack long enough, lots of things happen. Like, random cologne incidents. One of those games where they don't cleanse a totem. Where's the Cheryl from last game? Yes. Not gonna ask how, but listen, as we just learned, if you have a ball sack, apparently things just happen. So you should be on the lookout for that someday. Yes, if you have a ball sack, eventually you'll just... have things happen. So you should be on the lookout for a ball sack. Been around for 40 years. Well, I'm telling you, apparently, we're learning all kinds of things together. Random cologne spills on balls. Things just happen to balls. Sphing is really interested in this one totem now. Realize I haven't shredded anything today. How about we shred this green hood? again. I'll take it. They're very interested in totems now. It's very interesting. What? That was weird. I'm way over here, I'm back on the totems. Yeah. It's definitely gotten interesting. They went from not touching a single totem to wanting to touch all the things. Control for the win. Wait. Did I accidentally bring a Mori? I sure did. Also, hello, Ty. Pentamento. Let's put it back and see if it gets them killed. Unalived. Forces them to lose their battle with mortality. Bang, bolt something. I was really hoping that would work. Can't confirm it did not. Just spill on my balls. Yeah, how does it happen? Oh, nuts. Yeah. This feels more right, Ashwing. Yes. It does feel right. I wish these stupid rock stick figures would get out of my way. So, the plan for this build was something very different than what actually happened. Three whole streams. Look at that. You go, boy. Dude, it's crazy cat time every day. In case you haven't noticed, cats are crazy. Just wash them! Lord. I can't imagine a scenario in which you'd be gripping your balls while spraying cologne. Thought she went back. Oh my god, they're all in here. Yeah, I'm not a fan of cologne myself. I like camping. Good job, Nance. The other one went in there, I think. Wait. They actually came when the water pressure was... acting up. They messed with it and noticed it dipped really bad. Hey, look at them go. Now that I will defend. How do you unavoidably grip them? You have to, like, do this on purpose. So you have to have a reason to have your balls in your hand. We got greedy. They look weird gripped. Okay, to be fair, I kind of think they look weird not gripped. My friend hasn't seen it for this conversation. Look, I feel like you guys are the perfect candidates for this conversation. Conversation was mate was no, it's not late. It's the first time you actually spoke in chat. You grabbed coffee, but you didn't actually say a word. The bot won't speak unless you speak first. It's patrolling the gems right now. Ah. They have touched it. We have our first candidate for losing their battle with mortality. But first, a pit stop. Chico? Where'd she go? In a locker, I'm guessing? Many over there. Elmer's glue? At least it wasn't super glue. That would have been significantly worse. Gold plate their ball. Oh, did I not? Okay. Dang it. There's Nia. What do they think I have? Is. How about we put her here, where she wanted to be? Like they want to get out or something. Hey, Brandon. Is that a flashbang or is she just happy to see me? Where is she even going? Oh, that missed her by a small amount. What is Cheryl even doing? Oh man. You're no Elmer. Alright. So here's what we're gonna do. We're going to encourage them. Touch things you're not supposed to. I can never. I can never get this to work. There we go. If we have to be looking at the other one. They're already touching stuff. Not today, Satan. Oh, look. He threw a shack ballot. He didn't flashlight me that time. Why can't I figure this out? Who's Jeff? He's already used his life. He's so wiggly. Oh, that sound goes. Yeah, finally. Whistle set. Am I alone? I see them. Ding. I messed up. Or did I? This is a slow game. Oh, there he goes. He's captain of the lights team. And he already got rid of interesting. Ah! Handsaw for 3 on him. Seems solid. Touching things that don't belong to you guys will cause your early demise. They're very interested in the totems now. Kind of what I was aiming for. That's the one they couldn't have. A boring game.
Nice. We need to get one of them. I honestly think the only person it can be is Cheryl. Maria. Really? I missed her twice. Missed her. Went the long ball. Shit. Bungie will do that. This has to be a Swift. Like, there's no way. Like, there's no way. Ooh, Maria. That's her up there. And he finally got it. Do you have a bill? No. A bill. These things are mods breathing. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. I wonder where Maria is. Aaron? Question mark? No.
Legend. It's a little weird. It's just weird. I see you, Joe. We're not in the jar. There's more than one ace or guy or whatever. Yes, you're gone.
Ace, but where did he go? There he is. Oh, I'm done. It's brightly colored, but wait, why is he vaulting that? I have crowd control. I'd half a mind to leave him on the ground. Look, I'm concentrating. Imagine. Aceman's here, but I don't think I can get her into it. I'm gonna have to go for the safe option. Hey, and there were two. Portal that's out in the middle of nowhere has actually been useful. I don't know why he likes running here. I've got to get him. This isn't gonna do it. This is like an infinite. What a little turd. Gotta find a way to get this guy. That's not gonna do it. Did he magically get good at this game? They know how to get to all the places. No. I hope you brought him breakable. I really went over here and got him out. I will hook you. Where do you find your friend? Is he really just hanging out over there? Surely he's not doing a gen.
Alright, that'll wrap it up for this build test. We had some interesting games. I think this build in the right situation can be a lot of fun. It might not be my favorite build, but we will. Nevertheless, it was fun. Made for some interesting games. And then don't forget to like this video, subscribe, and we will see you in the next one.